My most abiding memory is the joyful ringing of church bells, which I'd never heard before. This is because I'd lived in France until war broke out, and I can't remember ever hearing church bells there, though they must have been rung. They were silenced throughout the war, as they were only to be used as a warning of an imminent invasion. We were living in Bournemouth, not far from the centre, and all the churches seemed to celebrate all day. I still associate bells with happiness and peace. I remember it was good weather, and there had been weeks of speculation about a German surrender. The revelations of the concentration camps had been broadcast a few weeks before. The images had given me nightmares. It was Tuesday, a school day, but I didn't go to school. I think we had a special meal my mother had planned for the great event, with tinned peaches, perhaps, as they were a great treat at that time. I also remember the sense of relief. We had lived through the Exeter Blitz, which was terrifying. Having witnessed nightly bombardments, we were always aware that it could happen anywhere at any time. On VE Day, neighbours welcomed friends, and I expect to open precious bottles of sherry or homemade wine to celebrate.
Suddenly being taken away, aged 8, with my school in evacuation to Broxbourne to live with a couple who had no children of their own, and fearing for my parents in London during the Blitz. While I was there, a bomb was dropped on a house 3 doors away, but nobody was hurt. Age 11, going to a secondary school which was evacuated to Keighley, Yorkshire, being again with a couple with none of their own children. After a year, the school returned to London. A bomb fell on the houses at the end of our garden, causing great damage and injury. A number of our neighbours were killed. Shortly after this, the next phase of bombing started, the flying bombs. Aeroplanes without pilots sent over to the UK from Germany, which would suddenly stop and drop, causing great damage and death and injury. I remember sitting and waiting for the engine to stop. After a time, they were replaced by rockets sent over with no advanced warning until the explosion. These did the most damage and of injury. I don't remember VE Day itself. I mean, I didn't go out on it. You know, so many people, of course, did spend VE Day making great pleasure. But I think I do sort of remember thinking, thank goodness it's all over, you know. Able to live in peace and calm, no dangers.
Come and feast your
Barbara Quantrell's memories of VE Day. She was 20 years old and she had a day off from work. She remembers walking from her home in Wood Green to Buckingham Palace with her friends. There were lots of flag waving going on as she walked along and people were very happy. She saw the King and his family on the balcony at Buckingham Palace. Then she walked home.
I was 16 then, at boarding school in Tiverton, North Devon. The first reaction in the school was one of relief, both among the masters, who had been saddened by the deaths of so many old boys, also among those boys with fathers and brothers serving in the war, who were now safe. On a lighter note, we boys keenly expected more and better school food. What a chance. For me, there was hope for my father, who was in the Japanese prisoner camp in Shanghai, hope for his early release and the end to the war in Japan. A service of thanksgiving for the war's end was held in the school chapel. We also listened in Great Hall to Winston Churchill's dramatic speech marking the day. I was in the school's cadet corps. A retired sergeant trained us teenage boys hard for war service with much shooting practice on a rifle range. I shot well and was awarded the status of marksman. I recall on VE Day the good sergeant expressing slight disappointment that our shooting skills would now be wasted. He almost sadly said to me, "You may be a marksman, Hopkins. Shame you'll not be using it now."
My name is Anthea Tinker, and on VE Day 1945, I was living outside Portsmouth. My father was a Royal Navy officer and was commander of the gunnery school in Portsmouth. On VE Day, I remember gathering in the street with neighbours and lots of American soldiers. They gave my sister and me sweets. One of them kept in touch for a long time and regularly sent parcels of sweets when he returned to the United States. I had previously seen the massed armies and equipment for the invasion, so the war was very real to me.
I think the first thing that I remember when the end of war was announced was a great feeling of excitement, because it meant that my brother, who was a prisoner of war in Germany, would be coming home. And my brother was my hero. And of course, I hadn't seen him for over 2 years. So the feeling of excitement was enormous. But there was also a slight sense of dread, as I think as far as my parents were concerned, because nobody was quite sure what had happened to prisoners as the war got towards its end, whether they were still safe or whether anything might have happened to them. So there was excitement, but mingled a little bit with fear. The second thing, of course, was a day off from school. Now, this was quite something. I went to school 8 miles away from Stratford, and to have a day off was almost unheard of. In fact, when my brother actually came home a few weeks later, my parents had to fight with the school, more or less, to let me come home from school to greet him. The school thought that doing lessons was more important than seeing my brother. The third thing was the excitement of the general population. Everybody came out of their houses and was excited and talking about it, but nobody quite knew what to do. There was a slight sense of, I don't know, sort of awe, wondering. And it took a bit of time to collect one's thoughts and for people to get together and organise the party. So it was a bit vague initially, but built up as people came home and joined in. The fourth thing was the church bells. Stratford Church has a wonderful peal of bells, and these bells, it seemed to me, rang out and rang out and rang out for most of the day. The bell ringers must have been exhausted. And in the evening in the parish church, there was, I guess, a spontaneous service. I don't know whether it was, well, it can't have been planned, but how people heard about it, I don't know. But I do know that my other brother and my parents and me, we all went off to the church service, and the church service was packed. And I can remember to this day the excitement which seemed almost to lift the roof off the parish church. And even the choir seemed to sing with added celebration. It was a terrific service, which lingers in my mind to this day.